A 2015 U.S. Department of State report says St. Lucia is a source and destination country for persons subjected to sex trafficking. The Trafficking in Persons report added there are indications internal prostitution of St. Lucian children occurs. Foreign women in prostitution are also vulnerable to sex trafficking. The report further noted that pimps, strip clubs operators, and brothel owners are the most likely sex trafficking perpetrators in the country. Human rights advocate Felicia Browne said there needs to be measures in place to stop this.
Yes, because it provides protection for the women. In terms of prostitution, we're not claiming that all women should engage in those activities, but what it will actually do is to provide protection for them. Because if you have traffickers bringing women in the state under false pretense, then the women would know, well, you know, he's or she's violating my rights. And so these are some of the concerns as we go across. We cannot change the idea that prostitution will never exist. It will exist. But what we want to do is also protect the individuals, the victims of those kinds of professions.
The call has been triggered by the arrest of 14 female foreign nationals at a strip club on Friday. The women were arrested for not having the requisite permits to work on the island. Brown says the whole matter reflects a blatant contradiction and ambiguity on the island's laws regarding exotic dancing and prostitution.
I believe that if it's regulated and women know what their rights are, like I said, in certain societies, we all know that these things do exist. But how do we protect women from any forms of violence or any type of forms of exploitations? And this is where the state has to make those kinds of decisions. It's a very difficult decision because we're dealing with exchange of sexual favors for monetary values. And so these are moral as well as social issues. But at the same time, we have to look at how do we eradicate some of the kind of exploitations that are happening. What we're actually seeing, which is very dangerous, is that we're seeing children, young children, being trafficked across the Caribbean islands, children under the age of 18. And so when these young girls go to these very islands and they go missing, these are some of the concerns that we have.
Brown says the legislation needs to be more effective of today's society.
If we do actually provide permits company permits for strip clubs, then the law has to reflect that, whether it's strip clubs legal or illegal within our state. And so we have to look at where the loopholes are so that we protect the rights of the visitors within our country and we protect the rights of business owners as well. Because we cannot be claiming that stripping, prostitution is illegal, yet at the same time, strip clubs in itself are illegal. So we have to ensure that the law is very clear and that persons know what their rights are. And so we're not only looking in terms of the women's rights are being ensure that the women's rights are being protected or the business owners' rights are being protected, but also patrons, persons that solicit those types of entertainment in those environments as well.
According to the St. Lucia Police Force, the law is silent in regards to exotic dancing and strip clubs. However, soliciting sex from an individual or individuals is prohibited. For the DBS News World, I am Sarah Peter.